Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. This is episode 7 of the 120 Days to Jam Use of English with Flash Isaac. I am excited about this episode because it is our first comprehension passage of the series, and you are really going to enjoy this episode in particular. I will display the questions, but I won't be able to display the passage. This is why you need to install the Flash Learners Jam application. We have 120 episodes in each subject, which means for your first subject, 480 video tutorials. And just imagine missing everything just because you refuse to install a simple app that costs almost nothing. So it will be very bad. So this is what you do. Install the Flash Learners Jam application, activate it, then go to question search. Type a wolf seeing a lamb. Immediately it loads, the passage will load. Then you can start following us. So I'll wait for you to do that. Now let's take a look at the questions. The first question here says, the charges levied against the lamb are dash. It simply means that charges were levied against the lamb. We shall therefore take note of these charges to be able to come back to this question. The next one says, the expression angry tone and terrible aspect refers to dash. Angry tone and terrible aspect was used in the passage. What was it used to refer to? The next one says, the expression when this excuse failed him suggests that. When this excuse failed him was used in the passage, what did it suggest? Now, it is not according to you or according to me. It is according to the passage. All your answers should be justified in the passage. You should be able to look at the passage and say, this is where I got my answer from. According to the passage, this is the answer. Not according to your feelings or according to English. Comprehension is according to the writer. If the writer says, Mayu is the best club in the world, whether you agree or not, whether you are supporting any other club, so long that passage is concerned, the question, which of the following is the best club in the world? Follow the writer and say Mayu. The next one says, which of the following aptly describes the morale of the story? It therefore means, as we go through the passage, we need to ask ourselves, what is this trying to teach us? Because we are required to use it to answer a question. And from the way the story ended, it can be concluded that the womb and the lamb parted amicably. Lamb did not survive the encounter. Wolf had encountered the lamb's parents. Lamb offended the wolf quite seriously. So, which of the following can we conclude from the passage? We are not concluding yet because we've not looked at the passage. If we look at the passage, or after we look at the passage, we can therefore conclude. Now, let's see the passage. A wolf seeing a lamb drinking from a river. Wow. Can you see that on your phone? A wolf seeing a lamb drinking from a river wanted to find a pretext for devouring him. He was looking for excuse to devour the lamb. pretext means excuse or false excuse, looking for a way or a wrong reason to justify your action. If I don't want to go to school tomorrow, I know that I don't want to go to school. But so that my parents don't shout at me, I will say, ah, mommy, my body is doing me somehow. So we are seeking for a pretext. A lot of us did it. You did it. I'm not okay. Just me somehow. Your mom will be like, oh, sorry. So that is a pretext, an excuse, a wrong reason to justify your action. So the wolf, seeing a lamb drinking from the river, wanted to find a pretext for devouring him. He stood up higher the stream and accused the lamb of muddying the water so that he could not drink. So already we know that he was looking, or he's looking for excuse to devour the lamb. Devour means to destroy, to consume, to eat hungrily or quickly. The first excuse was muddying. Muddy means to fill the water with mud or to make the water muddy. That was the first accusation. The lamb said that he only drank with the tip of his tongue, and that in any case, he was standing lower down the river and could not possibly disturb the water higher up. You see, I'm standing lower the river, you are up. So how can I disturb the one higher up? When this excuse failed him, so this excuse failed the wolf, because he obviously made up the excuse. That one failed him. And when that one failed him, he said, well, last year, you insulted my father. So apart from muddying, he accused him of insult, like to be rude, let's say insolent, or anything you know to be insult or to be rude. I wasn't even born then, replied the lamb. The lamb said, even that last year you said, I was not even born last year. You are good at finding answer, said the wolf. But what do you mean by taking up so much of the path where I am walking? He said, okay, you are good at answering. Now I'm walking. You are taking so much of the path, which means you are interrupting, or you are occupying where I am supposed to be. The lamb, frightened at the wolf's angry tone and terrible aspect, told him, with all due submission, with all due respect, that he could not conceive how his walking on such a wide path could occasion him inconvenience, which means interruption, that is inconvenience. Accuse him of muddying, insolent, or disrespect, and inconvenience. Now look at some words there. Frightened. Frightened means to be afraid or anxious. Alarmed, to be terrified, to be scared. So that is what it means. And the wolf's terrible aspect means he was his extreme tool, his angry posture. You are interrupting the road, you are passing, you don't want me to pass. Then, and he said, what? Exclaimed the wolf, seemingly in anger and indignation. The lamb said that he could not conceive how walking on such a wide path could occasion him inconvenience. And the lamb replied, what? The wolf replied, what? You are as impudent as your father, who seized me by the throat last year and caused me to be kept in a cage for 3 months. So impudent means rude, insolent, or wicked. We shall modify this later. So indignation, as used there, simply stands for resentment, anger, or annoyance provoked by what is perceived as unfair. If you will believe me, said the lamb, my parents are simple creatures. And impudence means impertinent, insolent, cheeky, disrespectful. My parents are simple creatures who live entirely by green stuff. We are none of us hunters of your species. Species mean kind, type, sort, genus. They are capable of interbreeding. We can marry, me and you, we can give birth. We are not even of that kind. We are different entirely. We are not of the same species, of the same genus, of the same kind, of the same sort. So, if we are not of the same sort, And we are also not a hunter of your species. It means we don't hunt your type. We don't eat your type. We don't fight your type. We are different. We don't go into your type. So since we don't hunt your type, how will you now say my parents did this to you? Ah, see, it's no use talking to you, said the wolf. Drawing up close to him, he throws in the blood of your family to hate us, wolves. And therefore, as we have come so conveniently together, I will just pay off a few of your forefathers' scores before we are part. So murder was also the charge, one of the charges. Murder. And he said, I will also pay off a few of your forefathers' scores before we part. So saying, he leapt at the lamb from behind and garroted him. Well, he killed the lamb by strangling. Which means there was, according to the passage, the lamb did not survive the encounter. And pay off scores means to get revenge. Looking at this story, what does it teach you? All the accusations levied on the lamb were false, and the lamb tried to justify the father. See, I am innocent. The wolf still killed him. Which means, if you've made up your mind to do something, no matter the excuse or whatever, you'll still do it. The wolf killed the lamb, not because of his offense or whatever, just because he had already made up his mind to kill the lamb. But this is a very sad story. Let's go to the question. The charges levied against the lamb are pollution, insolence, obstruction, and aggression. Pollution, that is muddying, insolence, being rude, obstruction, that is inconveniencing, interrupting the road. Then aggression, so you are rude, no problem, no need talking to you. B, exuberance, pollution, wickedness, and stubbornness. Exuberance is not really part of the charges. Stubbornness is also insolence, but let's see option C. Garrulity, loquacity, loquacious means talkative, pride, arrogance. All this, that is not a complete answer to the charges. D, greed. No, greed was not among. Wandering was not among. Insolence was among, and disrespect was among. Looking at option A, B, C, and D, the one that has the features we mentioned, muddying, which is pollution, insolence, like being rude, interruption or inconvenience or obstruction was among, then another rude again, being aggressive. So, you want to show me that you can do this? In fact, murder was even there, but the murder was not levied directly against the lamb, but the lamb parents. Your parents did this, your parents fought us, and the lamb said, we are none of us hunters of your species. So anyhow you look at it, option A is the correct option. The expression, angry tone and terrible aspect, refers to harsh voice and menacing posture. Like I already explained earlier, it does not mean towering size and thunderous voice. It does not mean sonorous voice and overbearing attitude. It does not mean loud voice and fretting movement. It means angry tone, harsh voice, terrible aspect, menacing posture. So that best interprets both statements. The expression, when this excuse failed him, suggests that A, the lamb was prepared for the charges levied against. The lamb wasn't prepared against the charges. B, wolf was uncertain of the charges levied against the lamb. If we say uncertain, it means he wasn't sure. But looking at this passage, he knew what he was doing, so he made them up. Obviously made them up. So not that he was thinking. Uncertain means, it could it be true or not true? Am I sure? So it's not about being sure or not. He knew what he was doing. Option C says, the wolf only made up the charges levied against him. Yes, he made them up. He was certain of what he was doing. He was sure of what he wanted. And option D, the lamb was more intelligent than the wolf. When the excuse failed him, doesn't mean the lamb was more intelligent than the wolf. The wolf knew what he wanted. He was looking for a means to an end. At the end, he still got what he wanted. So the lamb died. Which of the following aptly describes the moral of the story? If you have made up your mind to hand your dog, any rope will do for the purpose. D is correct. Option C says, the sins of the fathers are visited upon the children. The sins of the father are actually visited upon the children. But in this case, did the father sin? No, the whole father did not do anything. B, the law is weak in defense of the poor against the rich and mighty. There was nothing like law or law being weak and not weak. So all these things were not found in the passage. Let us use our head to answer the questions. And A says, no matter how highly placed he is in the society, the unmindful lawbreaker will always meet his nemesis. There was nothing like law and nemesis there. It was just someone trying to oppress somebody else and kill him. So nothing like breaking of law or nemesis, because the wolf did not get the repercussion for his sins, and the lamb did not even sin. It was just a levied charge against him. From the way the story ended, it can be concluded that the lamb did not survive the encounter. B is correct. A says, wolf and the lamb parted amicably. Amicably means peacefully. There was no hostility. That's not the case. The wolf had encountered the lamb's parents. The wolf never encountered the lamb's parents. Lamb offended the wolf quite seriously. The lamb did not offend the wolf. Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of this episode. See you in the next episode. And for your assignment, open the Flash and Nance Jam app, type. In fact, your assignment is go through the passage again. Open your Flash and Nance Jam app, type a wolf seeing a lamb. You see the questions, go through them over and over again and make sure you understand. If you are confused anywhere, reach me on any of my social handles. I am more than available to assist you. So that is it for today. See you in episode 8.